I heard that you want to learn some Audacity. Hey, what's up? Audacity beginner tutorial, quick 5 minutes, how to edit, how to record, how to save, how to export, how to import. Let's go.
To install Audacity, just Google it. Click on the website. Now click this download Audacity button. If you are on Windows, click this button Audacity for Windows. Click this first link, and now click this Audacity Windows installer. Just save it, and when the download is ready, run it and install as any other program. When you first start Audacity, make sure that you save it right away in the folder. This is important if you want to keep things in order and move project folder to another computer. Before we start to edit, we need some audio. I'll go to the YouTube library and download some music here. To import audio, you can go File, Import Audio, or just drag and drop the audio file from the folder to the Audacity. You can now see two waveforms. This means that this track is a stereo track. To make life easier, let's turn this stereo track to mono track. Click this little arrow and select split stereo to mono and delete the top one. Up here, make sure that the selection tool is selected or press F1 to select it. Now you can click anywhere on the track and hit the green button to play the song. If you click and hold, you can select which part of the track you want to play. Okay, let's stop it and go to the beginning. In this section over here, you can change the speed of the song, recording volume and playback volume. To cut parts of the track, select it and click this cut button over here or press Ctrl X. You can also copy and paste parts of the track. Now select the time shift tool or F5 and move this part around. As you can see, you are moving the entire track and you want to move only this part. To fix this, select your selection tool and select where you want to split the track. Now go to Edit, Clip Boundaries and Split. If you now select Time Shift tool, F5, you will be able to move this part around. If you want to silence something, select part of the track and click this silence button. Over here you can see standard undo and redo button and zoom controls. I usually use Ctrl plus mouse wheel to zoom in and out and home and page up page down keys to move around. To record your voice, make sure that you choose your microphone over here. You can see that I have 3 mics to choose from and I choose USB mic to record my voice in this tutorial. First, right-click on this mic icon over here and select Start Monitoring. You will now see this green bar moving up and down. This means that your microphone is working. Now speak something in the mic to test the recording volume. Move this slider to adjust the recording volume. Most important thing is that you don't want to go to the red section. It's very important, so keep it in the green or yellow zone. When you are ready, click the red button and record your voice. Hit stop button to stop recording. If you are not satisfied, you can delete the whole track by clicking this X button here. To make your recording sound better, select the whole track and go here and select Effects, Compressor, and make sure that Makeup Gain is selected. Hit OK. This compressor will make loud section quieter and quiet section louder. This means that your recording will sound more consistent. Now hit Effects again and go Normalize. Make sure everything is like this and hit OK. This will make your volume more consistent and you will be more pleasing to the ears. To export your recordings, go to File, Export and choose your export format. I recommend WAV format to keep the original audio and maximum quality.